the first year that we've had the performers that I've never met until tonight. Every other year, we've pretty much been friends with everybody. It's like, hey, you want to come play MC Bad with us? We're all networking together. And this year, after noticing all these great musicians around town that I've never met, I said, well, why don't we just do something different and have all new acts that we've never actually had to the BREASTFEST stage? So Dot and I got together, and after some YouTubing and whatnot, we came up with a final list of 10 really great singer-songwriter chicks that we were extremely excited about, and here we are.
Yay!
Everyone said yes.
Yes.
And as I mentioned earlier, this event had no overhead expense at all. Every single thing was covered by someone or some company or entity. And so every single penny that is coming through the door today and through the raffle today is going directly to the gathering place. So this is the first year that we can actually say that also. Thanks to Facebook, because usually we are buying ads and now we're buying Facebook, I guess.
It's services that address emotional, physical, spiritual, and social needs of those who are touched by cancer. They provide support to individuals diagnosed and their family members and friends at any point in the journey. At the time of diagnosis and during and after treatment, unfortunately, those that don't survive cancer, their family members still can go for as long as they want for support after. And so it's a very good organization all around. And Chris Byer, why don't you go ahead and shake her a little bit, because we didn't have a drum circle this year, so we need some. Okay, that was our drum circle. We've done a drum circle every single year. This is the first year we're not having one. John Adams usually hosts it, and as you can imagine, he's pretty busy right now. So with the Indians going to the World Series, so we gave him a little free time this year, so he can deal with that. And our first performer today is Ms. Vicky Chu, and she has her bass player Paul Lawson with her today. And Vicky she's been playing around Cleveland for a long time. At one time she admits that she actually wrote a letter to the Doobie Brothers and said, hey, if you ever need a chick singer, I'm your girl. So if you can imagine that Doobie Brothers, that would probably be my pick. In addition, she started playing guitar and writing songs at the age of 15, and she was inspired by groups ranging from the Beach Boys to the Platters, the Supremes, to Carole King and Stevie Wonder. And I'm going to reach back here and shut off this snare before she starts, but give a warm welcome to Vicky Chu and Paul Lawson.
Yay!
Thanks, you guys. Thanks, Tracy.
Romance in the summertime.
Website if you want to check her out. She has CDs available. And if you want to check her out online or any of her upcoming shows at VickyChuMusic.com, Vicky with an I. And
what's your next show? This afternoon at 5.
When is your next show besides?
At Max Pax
Mountains.
Alright, she's playing on December 1st at Max Pax Books. And Max Bax is actually one of our donate donated one of our baskets, so we wanted to thank Max Pax for that and for having local music in their establishment. Is Megan ready?
There's you, this young lady right here. Megan Zerke, she's a Cleveland native. She plays an eclectic mix of her own original music and covers that she makes into her own. She has released 3 studio EPs. I have one of them up here for sale, and they've been in rotation on area radio stations. She's been performing the national anthem every year at Progressive Field since 2013.
Go Trev!
Jealous. Jelly. Are you going to do it this year, or you already did?
I did. I played it in, or sang it in July, I think.
It's online, actually.
Yeah, probably on YouTube. Yeah.
She has a website, meganzerke.com. And with no further ado, ladies and gentlemen, it's my honor to welcome Megan Zerke to the BREASTFEST stage. P-L-E-U-S-S. So just switch that E and the U. You can see that in the program that her name is in there under the, I don't know what time it is.
I'm not worried about it happens.
3:15.
Under the 3:15 slot. She's played all over the world.
She's played in the UK, Ireland, Canada, Peru, and Ecuador. That's just some of the places mentioned. Her grooves and progressions are influenced by the likes of Joni Mitchell, Paul Simon, and Andy DeFranco. Her self-produced album, From Birth to Breath to Bone, is out on CD and vinyl. We have it up here today if you want to take her home with you.
Vinyl.
It's my honor to welcome Gretchen Plus to the BREASTFEST stage. Give her a warm up.
Thank you. Thanks everybody for coming out today, and thanks for having me. Tracy, thanks for getting a hold of me. I'm really glad to be here. And it's also fun just to be able to see all the other musicians playing, so it's an incredible bill this year. I was admiring it. So this song is a new one of mine.
Future is unclear. Let's predict the future is the only thing.
social needs of those who are touched by cancer. They provide support to individuals diagnosed and their family members and friends at any point in the journey. At the time of diagnosis and during and after treatment, unfortunately, those that don't survive cancer, their family members still can go for as long as they want for support after. And so it's a very good organization all around. And speaking of good, this lady up here, Angie Hayes, she brings an energy to the stage with an extra value of entertainment. With bells on her shoes and cowbells or a kazoo, the songwriter will bring a folk musical rhythm that will make you dance in your seat. Angie and her group will be releasing a new record in November called Straight On Till Morning. And without further ado, I'd like to welcome Angie Hayes to the stage.
Thank you so much. It's such an honor to be here. Thank you guys. Gretchen, plus, where'd you go? You're so amazing.
She did?
Okay. She's amazing. I'm a big fan of hers, so yeah. Again, thank you so much for having me.
Again.
smiles, not tears, and growth from fears. For spreading cheer, and we'll give our wings to them.
Plug their acoustics and do the real thing that's called acoustic. You gotta say, oh, I'm acoustic, but you're plugged in. You have a mic, you're not acoustic. Angie Hayes, everybody. Alright, so coming up next, we have this young lady here, Michelle Goff. I went to go to her Facebook page this afternoon to find out what can I say about Michelle when I introduce her. And I look at her Facebook page and basically it says, I write songs and sing them.
I'm like, okay, I think I'm gonna have to look a little deeper for this one. But so I did happen to find some other stuff about her. She professes about herself on her Facebook page that she simply writes songs and sings them. But she is actually an indie folk singer-songwriter, and she uses her word plays and melodies to bring her own unique twist to that genre. She's been hitting the Cleveland scene by storm, and she's releasing her debut album in 2016. Is it out yet, Michelle? Is your CD out yet?
No.
Okay, well, hopefully. You got another couple months to go. We'll be waiting impatiently. And we appreciate you plugging the BREASTFEST the other night on 91.1 WRUW. We wanted to thank WRUW 91.1.Martin for helping out with the promo on the radio.
Restaurant.
Cafe Avalon.
That is a gluten-free.
Brothers Lounge. Where's that place? Curvy Consignments and Big Dudes. The Gorilla Lakewood. I got Cafe Avalon. Who else are we got? Oh, Cafe Avalon is gluten-free, so. So we are, we got some good prizes. No one here has gotten paid. Everybody has volunteered, including the director and the raffle person, Amy Heap, who does our raffle every year. Thank you, Amy. And Bob Gedra is running the door tonight, today. And Chris Bahari always supplies us with these beautiful flowers. And each of the ladies takes one home, so don't forget to take one home with you. All right, so the Gathering Place is a place that offers a wide variety of free programs. And it's completely donation-based, their funding. So their services address the emotional, physical, spiritual, and social needs of those touched by cancer. They provide support to individuals diagnosed and their family members and friends at any point in the journey, at the time of diagnosis, and during and after treatment. So if you have gone through, if you've gone through this, you can go to the Gathering Place at no expense. There is support for you.
Not first.
About Kate, besides what I'm about to tell you and what you're about to hear, you can check out our website, katekuser.com. Kate is a singer, songwriter, and educator here from Cleveland, Ohio. She teaches voice at the Music Settlement. She mostly performs her music as a solo artist. Recently, she began collaborating and recording with the local talents in town, such as Mr. Matt Harmon.
Yeah. Also, really good.
Also an amazing singer-songwriter, and I went to middle school with, so just imagine. This is her dad right here, Jim Kuser, and he's going to be playing some percussion for you. We have over here on the fiddle, Becca Rhodes, and fresh home from Denver or Colorado, he's back, he couldn't stay away, G.S. Harper, give it up.
Thank you.
Thank you. rising sun.
Oh,
So we procrastinated for a few more months, and then September came along, and Dot said, are we going to do this or what? I'm like, I don't know. So she says, I'm going to come pick you up and take you to lunch. And about a half hour later, we had our list of girls, and we had our whole plan, and here we are. So we got to keep doing it. We're 16 years in. Thank you, Dot Martin, for keeping me going.
Yay!
I would not have been continuing without you, and that is the truth. Thank you to Mark Baker for running sound and managing the stage and keeping everything on top. And thank you again to Rebecca Jane for that wonderful set. As I mentioned earlier, we did not have any overhead costs for this entire event. And we want to thank all our sponsors, including all the people that provided, all the companies that provided the gifts today for the raffle. And in addition, we want to thank the FedEx store in Rocky River for providing us with our programs. And they printed them up for us in about a half hour this morning, and they said, eh, don't worry about it. We got it. So thank you to FedEx. And make sure you support that store, because they supported us.
Yes.
And they didn't have to do that. And take a program home with you, for God's sake. Okay, I saw that you were on your
city council.
Yeah. So she's a very active people person, musician, networking with other musicians, running open mic nights. So if you're ever out in Geneva, and I see there's a lot of rock stars in the house, yes. Like half of the audience is rock stars right
Please
now.
Please come so. Out, yes.
Go on out to Geneva at the Old Mill Winery and see Susan on Wednesday night. And without further ado, here's Susan on a Sunday night at Brothers Lounge here at BREASTFEST.
Thank you so much, Tracy Marie. Just an honor to be here. And thank you for putting this on every year. I know what that takes. So there's a lot of egos in the house. I know that could be tough. Some of us. I'm actually never comfortable singing my own songs, so I'm going to start out with not my own.
Fire.